us. Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday, dear Nasid. Happy birthday to us. Hip, hip, hip. Hip, hip, hip.
The two-day conference will serve as a forum where trustees will interface with the stakeholders to update them on the progress made and to recognize the valuable contributions made so far to the sustainability of the National Pension Scheme administered by the Trust. On behalf of the government, Vice President Dr. Mohamed Jolde Jallo thanked the management and staff of the National Social Security and Insurance Trust for the developments made so far since the inception of the institution. He urged stakeholders in the trust to deviate their investment to the country's healthcare infrastructure and housing facility that will meet the needs for citizens in both formal and informal sector.
Equally, you have undertaken the last couple of years innovative investment. I will come to that later, but you have increased and expanded your investment. And more importantly, you have increased pension benefits. I want to thank you for that. A critical challenge that is affecting pensioners and even active working force today in Sierra Leone is what we call housing poverty. Housing poverty and healthcare provision. Every sub-Saharan African country needs to spend 15% of its GDP on health. We have moved in the last 4 years from 6 to 11.4%. Despite that, you realize that today the study that was conducted by the technical team for SLESH clearly shows that out-of-pocket contribution for healthcare services in Sierra Leone is still very, very high. It's still very, very high. Average Sierra Leoneans spend a lot of money to access healthcare service.
Minister of Labour Alpha Timbo Esquire said the National Social Security and Insurance Trust, NASIT, was launched 20 years ago by former President Ahmed Tijan Kaba. He added one of the major reasons NASIT was formed was to allow workers to contribute to their own future retirement benefit by making regular payments during their active age.
We will pursue vigorously the vision of His Excellency the President, retired Brigadier Julius Maada Bio, in ensuring that a comprehensive social protection scheme is established for the people of Sierra Leone by promulgating a social protection bill that will eventually establish a social protection authority. This is very important for the people of Sierra Leone, as we have seen the gaps that NASIT has provided and some of the vulnerabilities that still exist within the vast majority of our people in Sierra Leone.
Director General National Social Security and Insurance Trust, Mohamed Fuad Dabo, said 20 years down the lane, NASIT is very proud of the stunning achievement they have made so far, most especially on the National Pension Scheme.
Honorable Vice President, please convey our thanks to His Excellency and that his manifesto promise he has delivered on that. Additionally, credible investment ventures for which there are viable markets, such as student hostels and affordable housing, have been identified. It gives me great pleasure, Your Excellency, therefore, Mr. Chairman, to announce that we have signed a memorandum of understanding with the Chinese Council International Corporation for International and Technical Cooperation for the construction of the hostels and 5,000 affordable housing units. There have been efforts to incorporate informal sector workers in the scheme. In anticipation of the possible participation of that sector, the Trust formed an informal sector unit in the operations division. There has, however, been great reluctance by this sector to participate in the current NASIT scheme. Management has formally approached the International Labour Organization for technical assistance for the establishment of an attractive scheme for informal sector workers in Sierra Leone.
Meanwhile, the events also saw the recognition of key players and staff in the development and growth of the trust. For SLBC News, Mariam Osuma reporting.